Hello everyone, this is Danny from creatingawebstore.com, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to change your default theme in Magento. In my case, I have Magento version 1.7.0.2 installed. I actually looked online at a couple of older tutorials about how to install themes in Magento, and noticed that the procedure is pretty much the same on all Magento versions. So even if you do not have this exact version, this video should help you, especially since I've just started using Magento. But keep in mind that I'm actually a web developer and I've been developing websites for a while, and I've dealt with many different software programs out there, so it's pretty easy to adapt to it. And from what I read online, you know, I thought Magento was going to be so much harder to deal with than those other programs that I've dealt with, when in reality it's actually pretty much the same. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to install the theme. There are actually a couple of different ways that you can do this. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to do this with a free FTP client called FileZilla. Now I was going to show you how to do this by using my web host's cPanel, but instead I figured an FTP client would be more of a universal approach. So if you don't have an FTP client, or even if you have Dreamweaver or whatever, that's fine, you can use that. But if you do not have an FTP client, you can actually go to filezilla-project.org and you can download your version. As you can see, they have Windows, all platforms here. I'm on a Mac, so I downloaded the Mac version. And after you install FileZilla, you're going to want to enter in the host, the IP address for your hosting account or server, the username and the password. Depending on which host you're with, some of them send you this information in an email, others ask you to create this information when you first set up your account with them, and others even have this information listed within the admin panel. So once you locate this information, log in, quick connect, get into your server, and then what you're going to want to do is, after you've found the theme and downloaded it, you're going to want to examine the theme. In my case, the theme was already it was zipped. So what I did is I unzipped it. You're going to want to do that as well. You're going to want to unarchive it if it is archived. I'm installing a Bluescale 2013 theme in this video. I actually found this theme for free online. If you visit my website, creatingawebstore.com, you'll see the theme that I downloaded, and I also have this tutorial written, so visit my website, creatingawebstore.com, and also I have a bunch of other themes, free themes available over there that you can look at. And so once you do that, like I said, you're going to want to get into your unarchived folder. And then, depending on the theme that you're installing, you're going to have different files and folders. In my case, I have a backward compatibility folder. What the designer did here is they made the theme compatible with older versions of Magento. For example, it's compatible with Magento version 1.4 and minor updated versions of it. There's also sample data, and there's some source files that you can look at. But what we're going to want is we're going to want the theme folder. Now, if you might not have this, you might just have the folders from within the theme folder. For example, as you can see here, I have an app folder, a media folder, and a skin folder. Now, interestingly enough, I read a couple of tutorials online that tell you to just upload your the app folder, media folder, and skin folder directly to your server. I'm going to tell you right now, please do not do that. If you do that, you're going to overwrite other files and folders that are already installed on your server. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to go within these apt folders and we're going to want to compare them. We're going to actually want to go into each of these folders and we're going to want to compare the contents of the folders with the contents of the corresponding folders on our server or hosting account. And I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So again, you do not want to overwrite any existing folders. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do this. Now, if you have additional folders, the procedure is pretty much the same, and I'm going to give you a better idea of how all of this works right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my FileZilla FTP client. So I have my theme downloaded to my desktop. Now, I have Magento installed in a subdirectory named Magento. If you have Magento installed in your root, which in most cases is public underscore HTML, then you will not need to locate this folder. Instead, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to locate these other folders. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my Magento folder, because what I did is a little while ago I created a couple of videos for WordPress, and I still have WordPress installed on this hosting account, and basically have Magento installed in a subdirectory, and this is what I'm working with. And as you can see, this is my Magento installation. This should seem familiar to you. And this is the app folder right here. And as you can see on my hosting account, I also have an app folder. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go into that app folder on the hosting account, and you're going to want to examine the contents of that app folder. As you can see, right in here I have a code, design, etc., and locale folder. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my code, because right here, let me pull this up because it's easier to see. In the app, I have a code, design, and etc. folder, right? So what I'm going to want to do is, inside the app, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the code first. And I'm going to go into the code here on the remote server. And as you can see, the directories from within my code directory on my remote server do not match the directories that I have in the app folder that I downloaded with the theme download. All I have is a local, and on my remote server I do not have a local. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload this local folder to my code folder on my remote server. Now, if you have a local folder, what you can do is you can actually go inside the downloaded local folder, and you can examine the files and folders from within it, and then upload each of those folders and files individually. Now, if your local folder has other files with the same name, you're likely going to want to overwrite them, because those will be files from your theme. So what I'm going to do here is, inside this code, I'm going to highlight the code directory, and here on the local, I'm going to right click and I'm going to left click on upload. And now you will see that my local folder has been uploaded. So now I have a local folder here. Now, next, what we're going to do is we're going to want to go into the design folder. And now we're going to want to go into the design folder here. And as you can see, in the design folder here, we have an admin, front end, and install. Here I only have a front end, which means that if I upload this front end, I'm going to overwrite the front end folder on my remote server. So I'm not going to do that. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in my downloaded front end folder, and I'm going to click on that. And you will see a default. Now we're going to check the remote server to see what's inside the front-end folder on the remote server. And once we go in there, we see another default, which means, again, we do not want to upload the default to the front-end, because if we do that, we're actually going to overwrite the existing default folder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click again on the remote server. I'm going to click again on default. And now we see other themes in here. See? And now finally in our on our local computer, you will notice that we have a BlueScale folder. In your case, it will be the name of your theme. And on the remote server, we do not have a BlueScale folder, which basically means that this folder contains our theme. So what we're going to do is we're going to highlight the default again, and we're going to right-click on this BlueScale, and we're going to left-click on Upload. And as you can see, now we have the BlueScale there, which BlueScale is the name of our theme. So now we're going to examine the rest of the folders, because the design, we already found our folder. The only folder that differs is that scale folder. That's the only folder that differs from the folders that we have on our remote server. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the etc. Folder. And here you will notice the modules. So what we will do is, again, on the remote server, we're going to click on the etc. folder here. And you will see that we have, again, a modules folder. But we also have other files in this etc. Folder. So in other words, if we uploaded the etc. folder to the remote server, we would actually overwrite the existing etc. folder, and we would lose everything that's from within it. So what we're going to do is, on our local computer, we're going to click on modules, and here we find one file, and here we find a bunch of files. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to just want to upload this one file, because if we would have uploaded the entire modules folder, we would have overwritten all of these files that are loaded in, that are already in the modules folder on our remote server. So what we're going to do is, after we highlight our modules directory on our remote server, we're going to go back here on this file, we're going to right click, and then we're going to left click on upload. And as you can see, we now have an XML file which we uploaded. And next we're going to go to media. See, because what we have is we also have media. In your case, you might not have media. This particular theme has a media folder. So what we're going to do is, on our remote server, we're going to locate the media folder. And as you can see here, we have catalog. So what we're going to do is, since in our media folder on our local computer we have the folder template, what we're going to do is we're only going to upload this template folder to our media directory. So we highlight this media directory, and we right click on the template directory, and we left click on upload. And now, as you can see, we have uploaded our template directory. It's actually finishing up right now. And once it finishes, we can move on to the next step, which is the skin folder here. So our skin is right here on our local computer, and as you can see, our skin folder contains a folder by the name of front end. And on our remote server, we have a skin folder, and again here we have front end. Again, if we would have uploaded the entire skin folder to the remote server, we would have lost all these other folders, admin and install. So what we're going to do is, on our local computer, we're going to examine the front end folder. And we're going to examine the front-end folder on the remote server. And as you can see, we have a default folder. So again, these match. So what we're going to do is, on the remote server, we're going to click on the default. And here we have other folders. And on our local computer, we're going to go into the default, and we have a BlueScale. As you can see, BlueScale is again the name of our theme. On our remote server, we do not have BlueScale because we never uploaded this theme. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that we highlight the folder default, and we're going to click on the BlueScale here. In your case, it will be the name of your theme. We're going to right click and left click on upload. So now, once this finishes uploading, it has finished. We are now ready to make changes in our admin panel because we have just installed all of our files and folders. Now, if you have additional folders besides the app, media, and skin, you will basically want to do the same thing. Just compare the contents of your folders on your local computer with the contents of your folders of the corresponding folders on your remote server or web hosting account. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go into our Magento admin panel. As you can see, I'm already logged in. And there are actually a couple of different ways that we can do this. We can change the theme on a page by page basis, or we can change the theme globally. In other words, when we change the theme, it will affect our entire store. Our entire store will be changed. So I'm going to show you now how we can do this on a page by page basis, and then I'm going to show you how to update your entire store's theme. As you can see, I still have the default Magento theme installed. So what I'm going to do is to change this information on a page by page basis, I'm going to go to CMS and I'm going to click on the pages link right here. Now, what I'm going to do is, as you can see, this is my home page page right here. So I'm going to click on this. And then you see where it says design. I click on design. And on the bottom here, I can choose a custom theme. And this is the theme that we just installed, the blue scale. You see how it's in the default? Magento basically pulls this information from that default folder, and as you can see, these are a bunch of other themes that you have installed on in your Magento powered store. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this blue scale, since this is that new theme that I just installed, uploaded, and I'm going to click on save page. And now when I refresh my home page, you will see that I have the new theme installed. Simple as that. So if you want to do things on a page by page basis, you basically just look at all these other pages and you follow the same steps. You just click on them, click on design, and then go down to where it says custom theme and you choose that new theme that you just uploaded. Now, if you want to make changes to your entire store, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back and change the home page back. So now that I have changed the theme back, when I go back to my home page and I refresh, you will see that we have our default theme back set up. So what we can do is to change the theme inside our entire store. What we do is we actually go to System, and then we click on the configuration link. And then inside the configuration here, we click on under General, we click on Design. And then where it says default right here, what we're going to do is we're going to type in the name of our theme, which in my case, it's that blue scale again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in blue scale, and then I'm going to click on save config. And now when we refresh, we will have the blue scale theme installed throughout our entire store. Now, keep in mind that some themes get a little fancy and they will have you update other parts of your site. For example, your columns and for example, this particular theme, this blue scale theme has a README text file here. And what it says is it tells me to go to this website for an installation guide. And that website's installation guide basically tells you how to make other adjustments to your store so that it's 100% compatible with the theme. So other than that, that's pretty much it. As I've said, it's easy to do, nothing difficult about it. And I actually, a little while ago, I installed the theme in PrestaShop. And to tell you the truth, it's pretty much the same as installing a theme on Magento. Please visit creatingawebstore.com for Magento themes. Thank you very much for watching, and please stay tuned for more e-commerce related videos.